good afternoon, although it might not be afternoon when you're watching this, because of course it can be watched any time, so it might be good evening, good morning, good day, but here and now it's afternoon and it's lovely to be playing for you. And that little piece is a number called the Wurlitzer March, which I first knew many years ago when the late Arnold Loxham used to open concerts with it. And it's something so familiar and it settles me down a little bit. Here's a song that I first became properly aware of some years ago when I was driving home late one night and it came on the radio being sung by Neil Sedaka, although it's very different from the repertoire that he would normally have sung. And so much as we like daylight in Pollokshaws, it would be perhaps rather romantic to experience moonlight in Vermont.
Thank you.
right in Vermont. There are some stage musicals which, although the songs they contain are old, perhaps from the 20s, 30s or 40s, the actual show which contains them is much more up to date, and there was, in the later part of the 20th century, a great fashion for taking songs by composers and constructing whole musicals around them. Shows like Crazy for You, that was one which took many songs by Gershwin, which originally had been in all sorts of different shows, and compiled them with a brand new story, and a whole wonderful new musical was created. Similarly, the musical Me and My Girl, it originally existed as a film called The Lambeth Walk, but in the 1980s, Stephen Fry, of whom we see such a great deal in television these days, took all the songs from Lambeth Walk and a very close approximation of the story and put together a whole new musical which he called Me and My Girl. Now, all the songs were by the composer Noel Gay, every one of them very well known. So here is a selection of some of the better known tunes that came from Stephen Fry's 1980s production of Me and My Girl. was a selection, as I said, from Me and My Girl. Here's a little tune from the 1940s, which you may or may not know, but which I'm very fond of, and it is entitled Get Out and Get Under the Moon. Get out and get under the moon, if only we could. Here is a little waltz I've been playing for a very long time, originally French, called La Petite Valse, and when it came to Britain, they didn't change it very much. They simply called it the Petite Waltz. In the early part of my career, quite a lot of my living was earned from playing the piano in lounges and dining rooms in some very smart hotels and restaurants, and I had quite a long period playing for Sunday lunches at Glen Eagles, and you came to know the tunes that would very often be requested, Rhapsody in Blue being one. There was one particular tune that seemed to be requested more than any other, and it wasn't any of the ones that I think you might guess, and yet at least once every two or three weeks someone would ask me to play it, I'll play it now, and you might know it. Victor Young's immortal song or piece, My Foolish Heart. When I was first starting out as a professional musician, one of the best friends to me in the music industry and my mentor really, to whom I owe a great deal, was an Australian pianist who had lived in Scotland for a very long time, whose name was Peggy O'Keefe. She and I used to do many shows in which instead of a band or an orchestra, they would have two pianos, and Peggy and I would play those two pianos. And we would often do features in the show to bridge a gap or to cover scene changes. And we together put together a medley of the music of Rodgers and Hart, which I later adapted both for piano solo and for organ. Rodgers and Hart, of course, Lorenz Hart was Richard Rodgers' writing partner long before he tied up with Oscar Hammerstein after Lorenz Hart's death. But some of the tunes they wrote still remain in the standard repertoire to this day, some of which you're about to hear. So a selection of music by Rodgers and Hart. Thank you. ages and heart. One of my great heroes of the organ world was an organist who was very well known in those circles. He was born in Keighley, Yorkshire, in 1929, and his name was Brian Rodwell. I think it was really Brian Rodwell who first inspired me to start playing theatre organ. I used to hear him when the previous organ that belonged to the society was installed in the Civic Centre at East Kilbride. And he had a little party piece that he used to play, which intrigued me as a child. And as an adult, I learned to play it. And I'm going to play it for you now. I'm sure if you've heard me play anywhere before, I'm sure you've heard it, because I put it in very often. I'm getting to the stage I've barely got the gall to keep including it in programmes, but I've put it in for you today. This is Brian Rodwell's take on T for Two.
Thank you.
Broadwell's arrangement of Tea for Two, which came from the musical No No Nanette almost a century ago. Well, I'm coming up to my last number now, and there are a few people I really should thank. Of course, first of all, SCOT, the Scottish Cinema Organ Trust, for inviting me to do this and for hosting the concert and maintaining and providing and cherishing this wonderful instrument. To Pollokshaws Burgh Hall, who keep and maintain and run this hall so well. To Glasgow City Council, who have given funding for this wonderful series of concerts, which we're very lucky to have. And to Andy and David Ford for filming and sound. I always like to close a concert with something rather vigorous. And when you want vigorous, you don't get better than the Russian composers like Kachaturian and Rimsky-Korsakov.